Thank you. It was shortly after that. Shortly after that.
It don't have to be no fancy. It just has to be us saying, look, this is what it's about.
Well, you did move into my house. Never even asked him. He just showed up with him and his daughter and his daughter's daughter and put another one. And I'm like, what the hell?
Hey, man, I still got so much to learn.
Over and stuff.
Rob did that dance one night in the middle of a fucking show.
Well, getting up there, man.
Fell over and fucking stopped and fucking. I almost called 911.
Wow. Oh, yeah, I know.
So we stepped up and me and Joe and Rob and Mark played a bunch of stuff.
I called 911. In the last 3 minutes.
My Rob?
No, one myself.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah, it was probably moving.
I went to the fire department one time because I thought I was going to pass out. I was getting sick. Cutting grass.
I'm a man of a few words. I usually just come up here and do my damn thing with the music and with the fellas, and I get the hell on out. But, you know.
This better be good.
My buddy Dave. That man has done so much for me, man. When we first met, I used to literally walk the fuck to work, man. 4 miles on foot, back and forth. This man put me in a van. Shit's still running after 3 years, you know what I mean?
Hell
and
yeah.
He gave me no shit. We store all our gear. We transport all our gear to and from gigs. Hell, the van done paid for itself with the gigs that I've gone to and from. Allowed me to transport gear to record our record, you know, to demo and go perform at places. Long and short of the story is basically I'm saying this is a good dude here behind us. And I ain't telling y'all no news because I wouldn't have met them. I wouldn't have met them without y'all. You know, if he didn't meet y'all and come here, Studio 113.
Yeah.
This band couldn't be shit without Studio 113. So
amen.
Now in our darkest hour, we tried to push it on Saturday, but unfortunately the venue owner wanted Friday because Saturday was a good seller for him. We're going to do a fundraiser and benefit of his surgery on the 31st. And I'm embarrassed, you know, I feel like a beggar sitting up here because you guys are friends, you know what I mean? Damn near family. And I feel ashamed to be begging family, but I know it would mean a lot to us. It would mean a lot to him specifically to show up. Even just for a moment, you know, 15, 20 minutes of your time out of support, not just for him, but for this shit called cancer that's eating away at our loved ones, man. You know, and that's the beautiful thing about this motherfucker. Despite everything, his daughters and shit, he wants to do a fucking benefit to raise awareness. I mean, what the hell? So please help us as you have so many years, you know. Dave, you know what you've done for the band. You know what you've done for this man. I don't got to air out our laundry, man. But sometimes it ain't about favors. It ain't about money. It ain't about what we do. It's about presence. It's about showing our faces and saying, hey, man, I'm here for you. And after the 31st, I'll be sitting right here waiting for you to come back to us. So, guys, just don't take this as a deviation. Party your asses off on Friday on our behalf. But we specifically started the show early as shit on 5 o'clock to 1 o'clock. So from 5 to 7, I've already discussed it with the venue owner. It's going to be everything you drank or eat, you know, that's on that menu that's going towards those proceeds. It's going to go straight to him and the benefit.
Yeah.
So it ain't going to cost you nothing if you was hungry. Go out here, eat dinner. Boom. You spend an hour from 5 to 6. If it's $10, if it's $20, it goes to him. It ain't costing you nothing. It's going to your belly and it's helping him at the same time. So I won't take more of your time. I won't take more of the practice's time. But I thought I'd put it out there. I know there's a few people, like Tez already said, that he's going to come out, and I know he will. And like I said, man, even if you just share the word or help us share the word, it'll be awesome. Thank you. We want to keep rocking.
All right.
Yeah. All right.
Bless you. What time are you guys going to start playing?
7.
Really?
Yeah, we're out.
What's the location again?
Cosmos.
The music starts at 7. We got a couple of our buddies. That's one of the reasons I wanted to do it on Saturday, because I figured, you know, if we had done it on Saturday, then some of the boys from here could have played. But unfortunately, the venue owner, you know, he didn't want to give up such a big night. But he was cool enough to give us, you know, from 5 to 7 that all the proceeds are going to go towards the cause. So, you know, that's more than we can ask for. You know, the guy don't owe us nothing, you know. So if you guys can make it, even if you can't make it, you know, share the word with somebody who can stop by if they're gonna eat dinner. It's gonna be on newspaper. It's already on Burning Pond, I think. So, yeah, we don't play. I think 10 o'clock is when GTD hits the stage. But we got Swamp Rats, which is more of a bluegrass kind of band, and we got and then we got Antiques Roadshow that's coming up, and then also we got the Big Bad Kids. So, Jamie, I know you got a kick-ass rocking band. We wouldn't mind having a fourth band if you're free, brother. I ain't saying nothing else. It's gonna be Friday from 5 to 1 o'clock.
Yeah.